タタラタタタタタタラ。Captain's log, mid-afternoon. After our big success in communicating with the race known as Ducky Zero, we decided to go boldly forward to another arm of the galaxy known as the Attic. There we met a race called the Perix, and we attempted to communicate with them also. However, things haven't gone quite according to plan, and there are still difficulties. However, we will continue to endeavour to get to know this race and befriend it. Hi folks, yes, following the mild success with the Ducky Zero, in other words getting it to work without blowing anything up in the process, there was another keyboard, a Perix, in the Attic, which pretty much suffered the same fate. There's a button on the side with which you use to trigger off the light. However, as you can see, this is a membrane keyboard, and on top of that, it's lit at the back by this panel, which is actually an RGB panel. Now, at one point, when I was poking around with my ever-trusty multimeter, what actually happened was I seemed to have upset the logic, and the red LED stayed permanently on whenever I connected the panel. However, I have now concluded that that must have been some stray voltage, because what I did to try and take advantage of that was say, bugger this, and rather than mess around, I simply crosswired the blue and red. However, it was never going to be quite that easy, was it? No, not where I'm concerned. So what I basically tried to do is, here's the panel. I attempted to feed in, poking around with the aforementioned wonderful piece of kit. The probes triggered something, I'll be buggered if I know what. I thought, I know, stuff this, I'll take the 5 volts off the USB feed. However, what happens inside is that the USB comes down to micro USB, doesn't it? Oh, joy of joys. And attempting to, if I just take this off here for the minute, or just do something, attempting to try and solder into this, right up here. Not a frigging hope in hell. That was literally just trying to go too far. I attempted to desolder it from the board, but that was no joy either. However, I did notice that it's got another USB port that you can plug in a supplemental device to, like a memory stick or some such, and it will carry it through the board itself. Now, I noticed that this appears to have rusted. Some water must have got on it at some point. So what I'm going to try and do is to desolder that and take the voltage feed off that, which should be 5 volts DC, after all the rest of it that has been through the circuit. And, and I'll attempt to wire that into the RGB LED panel and see if I can get something from it. Ultimately, I don't need the red or the green, just the blue, so hopefully it'll be relatively straightforward. And yes, that's my relatively straightforward, bog-standard soldering station. Nothing special. I've got some tips for it, but I still currently prefer to use this one, which some people don't like. But yeah. So, onwards and downwards. Catch you in the next video. I shall continue to venture boldly forth. Captain's log, after a cup of tea. We have managed to talk with the Perix and have successfully entered negotiations. I'm sure that we will make progress with this, and that now it is all a matter of just dotting the I's, crossing the T's, and tidying things up. Yeah, I was quite fortunate. At one point I thought there was some pulsing going on, but apparently not. As you can see, it's relatively straightforward. I managed to get the voltage out of the USB socket's extension, which there's the old USB socket, which I don't know if the autofocus is going to do its job here. But as you can probably see, that is... hello computer. I can't even see the screen myself yet. but that is actually quite badly corroded. But anyway, managed to get the voltage out, and there are also two 100 ohm quarter watt resistors in parallel there going into the blue line, and yeah, just the negative going in, and we have light, we have blue light, yay! So now it's just going to be a matter of tidying this up, soldering things in on a slightly more permanent basis, putting the keyboard back together, and seeing whether or not I've wrecked the membrane connection. But yeah, it's looking good, and if it is, then this is one more keyboard that can be rescued from the attic, and yeah, has successfully turned, hopefully, from a complete waste of time into from a discarded project, which never, in other words, it was money spent on a keyboard, which then turned to have a problem with the KVM turning the LED off, and fortunately I think we've managed to get around it. And the system is RGB, and it could do multiple brightnesses and all that clever stuff, yada yada yada, but pretty much I've thrown all that to the wind, and pretty much had to, basically, just to get the damn thing to work. But working and getting some value out of it is a lot better than it just sitting in the attic doing sod all. So, yes, another project complete! Hey! Here we are, the final test. It's hooked up to the KVM over there, and I'm just going to flip it between screens. And as you can see, it doesn't even blink. The only thing that does blink is the keyboard numlock and yada yada, which will go depending on until they've talked with the machine and come back or not. But the second machine is actually off, which is hence they're not lighting. But yeah, it's another keyboard saved. Unfortunately, the volume wheel has a red LED under it, and it's tied to the keyboard, soldered on, and I'm not sure how easy it's going to be to get that off. However, you know, that being red, it's not a big deal. I can easily live with that. And the caps lock themselves, rather than having lights behind the key and the scroll lock. Print screen, no. That's interesting, I think that I've lost scroll lock. Or is it shift lock? Looks like I've either lost scroll lock, or the machine just doesn't support it for whatever reason. Who knows? But yeah, not too bad at all. Whew. What can I say? System saved. In order to celebrate, it was cleaned, and I'll probably press it into permanent service on the other side of the room, serving the servers. Wow. I got to admit, that was a close one. Bye for now.